Yo, what is up, YouTube? Today is April 9th, 2018, and this is another edition of my vlog series, post-quitting work, hashtag I quit my job, which is basically a joke at this point, just like hashtagging that and saying it in the videos. But right now, as you can see, I'm icing my foot. This is the day after the 10K, so I ended up running it. All was good, but I had a little bit of a hiccup. So where we last left off in the vlog was day four of the vlog. I was making my kale smoothie recipe, having some fun with the Vitamix blender, being healthy, running, training a whole lot. I had my next plan was to run 6 miles on Friday, which would have been day five in the series. And then the 10K was yesterday, which would have been day seven if you're following me right now. Sunday, April the 8th was the 10K. So on Friday, I wake up, I'm getting ready to run 6 miles in preparation for the 10K, and I'm 2.5 miles into my run, and I ended up like spraining my ankle, which was so unfortunate. I was really hoping something like this wouldn't happen because I was kind of training above my means. I didn't really give myself enough time to run a 10K properly. I just started training probably 4 weeks ago from not running in a really long time. So I know I rushed it. Obviously, it's possible 6.5 miles a 10K isn't something like extremely ridiculous. You could just walk it, but I wanted to get a good time and be healthy and run. And I had been running at around an 8 to 9 minute pace. So I'm just going to average it out and say like 8.5 minute mile. That was kind of my average. So after spraining my ankle, it's not that bad of a sprain. I don't want to over exaggerate it. It just is lightly sprained in the front, and the top of my foot really hurts. Like the very top of my foot, every time I walk, it's really painful. But after a lot of ice and stretching, I was debating, what should I do? Should I run and risk further injuring myself? Should I just not go to the 10K and just chalk it up? Should I go and walk it? I was kind of in a weird spot because I really wanted to run the 10K, and it's just something that, you know, I signed up for. I don't want to quit. I don't want to not do it. I had told people I was doing it. I was really stoked about it. After leaving my job, this was something that I was really excited about doing. I forgot to include that on Saturday, my girlfriend and I had plans to hit up the cryotherapy for the first time. So I mentioned in my day four vlog that my girlfriend got us passes, one-time passes, to go try the cryotherapy at a new place in our city. And I was debating whether or not I should do this after the race or before the race, but since I had this ankle issue, I figured I could use all the help I could get. I might as well go before, stretch out, and feel really good for the race. But it turns out it was something I already knew, but once I got there, I forgot that you need to wear slippers and gloves to cover your extremities from getting too cold. So if you have an ankle problem or like a problem with your finger or something like that, it's really not gonna help because you're wearing gloves and slippers, like I said. But anyways, the experience ended up being so amazing. I'm gonna include some footage in of it right now. It was amazing. You go in the chamber, it's negative 249 degrees. That's the lowest it will go for a first timer. We did 2.5 minutes, but when you come back or you continually keep going, you can actually go colder and colder. They just have a lot of disclaimers and stuff like that and things. They don't wanna rush somebody into like negative 330 degrees or whatever the lowest temperature is. But this one, the center does go into the negative 300s, which is amazing. I thought it really capped out at like negative 250. But anyways, we did the 249, like I said. Ended up being a great experience. I'm gonna make a whole video about it because I love this place so much. I'm definitely gonna be going back. Owner is amazing. It was a really great experience. So a video of that to come. So like I said, I put the icing and stretching into high gear. I found an ankle brace from high school. I had actually like fractured that ankle in high school. So I usually do have a lot of issues if I'm playing basketball, running a lot with my right ankle. So I probably should have been wearing the brace to begin with. So I put the brace on, did all that stuff. I tried running. It still hurt incredibly bad. But come race day, I was like, you know what? This is going to happen. Let's just do it. If I have to walk the whole thing, that's fine. And I was running the race with my buddy Chris. And once we got there, I had the ankle brace on. I started running with him. Me and him were talking. Obviously, I wanted to keep pace with him. That was the original plan for me and him, to run the entire race together. So he gave me a lot of motivation. And what I did is every time my foot hit the ground, that's when it hurts because it's on the top of my foot. So what I did is I kind of ran with my one foot normal and my right foot, I was running on like the side of my foot, which was definitely not good. It was kind of giving me extra pain up my calf, but it was releasing or relieving some of the pressure that's on the top of my foot by running on the side. I don't know if that was a good or bad idea or not, but I ended up doing that and running through the pain with him for the first 3 miles, which was great. And then I walked a little bit, and then I ended up running the entire race and finishing within, I finished in 1 hour and 8 minutes, so 68 minutes, and I stopped to walk probably 3 or 4 times. So I ended up working out. Chris finished in about 1 hour, and so he was like 6 to 8 minutes ahead of me, and I think it was like 1 hour, 1 hour 2, and then I finished 1 hour 8. I'm still really happy with that. I think if you do the math, it's like a 10 minute and 50 second mile or something like that. It's above 10 and a half minute mile and under 11, and I'm happy with that. It's a couple minutes back from where I would have paced myself. I would have liked to have averaged like 8.5 or 9. But really, a couple minute difference isn't that big of a deal. I'm not finishing. Like, it's not an actual race to me. It was more about just finishing and doing it. And they actually gave out like a really cool medal. I was surprised for just a 10K. It's actually a really nice medal and a really nice t-shirt. And like I said, since I had never done a 10K before, for the amount of money, it was like $25 or $30 to sign up. They give you a free shirt. They had fruit at the end, water, all this stuff. And I feel like that's worth it. I mean, you get your money back for doing this thing. Plus the positivity, the energy there. It's just incredible. So many people running, helping each other out, saying positive things. There's so many people like around the race supporting you. I don't, you know, they're volunteers. And I don't know, it's really nice. Not that I got like emotional, but you feel great doing something like this and being involved. And I don't know, it didn't really hit me until the end. There's so many people cheering and my ankle was killing me. You see the finish line and like everybody, not everybody, but I think a lot of people, including myself and Chris, once you see the finish line, the pain goes away. You can sprint to it. You're just so relieved and everyone's giving you a high five and they give you the medal. And that stuff was great. And my girlfriend was there to cheer me on. Videotape with the DSLR. I'll mix some footage into that. And it was all good. So I'm really proud of myself for not giving up, not, you know, withdrawing because of the ankle pain. It could have been something I definitely could have done. And hopefully I don't pay for it and I didn't cause like any more extra damage to my foot. I woke up this morning, it hurts a lot, but nothing out of the ordinary. But when I touch it, it's visibly inflamed. And when I touch it, it feels like it's loose on top compared to my other foot. So I'm a little bit worried about that. But hopefully, like I said, it's not that bad. And we'll go from there. So anyways, that's it for the 10K. It was all good. Still got the big beard. I was going to shave it for the 10K and just run with the mustache. But, you know, once you get a beard this long, it's hard to shave it, even though I don't like the way it looks, because it takes so long to get here that I don't want to just give up on it yet. But we'll see. I definitely eventually got to get rid of it. But for now, I'm the classic bald guy with a beard. And yeah, till the next portion. Later.